Hello, and welcome to Hydrology Studio. This video is going to demonstrate how to use the trial route feature in Hydrology Studio. The trial route feature eliminates a lot of guesswork by giving you the ability to add and modify outlet structures while doing the pond routing in real time. This procedure dramatically reduces time spent on your design. I've opened up the same project file that was created in the pre and post development video. Hopefully you saw that earlier. Here, you'll see hydrographs 1 and 2 representing the pre- and post-developed states, as well as a pond routing step, which is hydrograph 3, named Pond Route. I'm going to select that hydrograph and click on this ellipsis button to open up the pond designer. Now, I'll take you through the steps used to design the pond that was presented in the pre- and post-development video. It begins by estimating the required storage. Now typically this step is optional, but if you ever plan to use the trial route feature, which is what we're going to do here, you'll need to use it. We'll choose hydrograph 2 for the post-developed, and hydrograph for the pre-developed, and click estimate storage. And checking the 100-year requirement shows that we need just under 10,000 cubic feet of storage. Now let's click next to move on to step 2, where the physical dimensions of the pond are set. Now, I won't spend a lot of time on this step because every site has its own constraints. Your objective here is to size the physical pond so that it contains enough storage to meet the requirements. In our case, 9,757 cubic feet. I've made a 30 by 30 trapezoidal pond with 2 to 1 side slopes and is 7 feet deep. Always click apply on this step, even if you're just editing an existing pond. Looking at the surface chart confirms my pond is what I have designed, and the stage storage chart proves I have enough storage. So let's move on to step 3 and add the outlet structures. The first thing I want to look at is the stage versus queue chart. Once the storage has been estimated and your pond has been sized to match, Hydrology Studio develops a target stage discharge curve for you to use as a guide in selecting your outlet devices. That curve is this heavy magenta colored line right here. And you'll notice that the appearance of this trial route window down below. Our objective is to create a stage discharge curve which matches the target. And this can be accomplished by selecting outlet structures one by one and making adjustments until the actual stage discharge curve matches the target. If you've read my blog on pond design or read through the user manuals for the software, you'll know I'm an advocate of designing outlet structures beginning from the downstream end and working up. After all, we're dealing with hydraulics, subcritical flow regimes, and energy. And what happens downstream always affects the upstream conditions. As you recall in an earlier video, we're working with 3 return periods, so we'll design a multi-stage outlet structure, one that looks similar to this one here. So the most downstream device here is the culvert. So let's add a culvert. And while adding devices, I want to view the target stage discharge curve. And since the culvert is the final most downstream device, it needs to be able to pass the highest expected flows. In this case, the 100-year queue of around 16 CFS. And ideally, we would size this pipe to limit flows to exactly that. While possible, it's not probable because we're limited to pipe sizes that are commercially available. But we'll see. Based on my experience, I'm going to try a 15-inch. Notice how Hydrology Studio has already set the invert elevation to match the bottom of the pond. Its length is at 25 feet, and it's at a slope of 0.5%. Click the Add Apply button, and our chart is updated with the new culvert. And notice that about stage 5.6, the culvert is only producing around 13 CFS, but our target is around 16. So this culvert is too small. So let's try the next size up at 18 inches. Now the culvert is producing around 19 CFS. And this exceeds the target queue of 16, and that's okay. But we will need to use a secondary device to control the upper 100-year frequency. Our next task is to pull our actual target queue line back to match the target because this culvert on its own is allowing way too much outflow. So let's add our next upstream device, the orifice. The orifice will be used to control the lowest frequency, in our case, the 2-year event. As shown here on the target curve, that's just over 8 CFS. So let's try a size of, say, 12 inches in diameter. In Hydrology Studio has already set the invert elevation. Thank you. We will check this as a multi-stage device, which will send its flows through the culvert. Add that. It appears that our orifice is too small, as it has pulled the total Q-line back a little too far. So let's try a bigger orifice, say 15 inches. There we go. Nearly perfect, as it matches the target Q-line all the way up to about 8 CFS at elevation 1004. To make sure this device will actually work, let's perform a routing. You can do this by simply clicking the trial route. And as you can see, the actual peak Q for the 2-year event is just under our target at 8.11 CFS. And we'll call that good. Now all we need to do is to push our target Q line forward, beginning at about elevation 1004, it looks like. And as shown on the trial route table, it's actually 1003.9. This next device needs to be able to pass a lot of flow, more so than an orifice, because the target Q line really starts to take off. That calls for a weir. So let's add a weir. And we're going to make it rectangular for simplicity's sake. And where do we set its crest elevation? Well, we don't want it interfering with what we already have. So we'll set it to the maximum water surface elevation produced by the previous frequency, in this case, the 2-year, and it's at 1003.9. So let's just set it just above that at 1004. And as for the crest length, let's try 2 feet and see what happens. This is also a multi-stage device. Add that, and lo and behold, the weir did its job. In fact, it follows the target Q line all the way to the end, which means we won't have to add any additional devices for the 100-year event. And that's good news. Let's do a trial route and see. And that shows a maximum Q actual of just over 12 CFS, which exceeds our target. It also exceeds the 100-year target, but it's very close. So let's just make an adjustment to the crest length and reroute. This time I'm going to try 1 foot. Click apply and then trial route, and perfect. It's got the actuals to just below the targets. The heavy lifting is done. Now we just need to find a home for the orifice and the weir. In other words, we need to add a riser structure to serve as a container. So let's switch over to the schematic where we can see what's going on. Here we see the culvert, the orifice, and the rectangular weir. It also shows the maximum water surface elevations for each frequency. What I want to do now is to add a riser structure to hold the orifice and the weir. And I want to set it to just above the highest water surface elevation, which is right at 1006. So I select riser, and it can be a circular or a box, it doesn't really matter in this case. And we're going to set the crest elevation at 1006. I'm going to set the crest length to something nominal like 12 feet. And this can be further reduced down later to save construction cost, but you want to make sure it provides enough space for the devices it holds. Next, click Add Apply to update the drawing. And clicking Trial Route updates the schematic with the water surface elevations. And as we can verify, the riser has not affected the routing results. Our pond design is now complete. We just need to return back to the basin model where we can complete the routing we started earlier. And I'll select Pond Route Hydrograph and click Compute. That's it. Clicking on the Charts tab shows us the results. Hopefully this video has given you some insight and guidance on how to approach your next detention pond design. The procedure should help save you some time and frustration, regardless of what hydrology software you're using. Just remember to always design your devices starting downstream and work your way upstream. Add each device at a best guess size, then perform a trial routing to determine if that device is sized to meet its criteria. If not, make adjustments until it does. Continue this process of adding new devices until all event criteria have been met. Thanks for watching, and thanks for choosing Hydrology Studio.